Now that we're ready to start, we're gonna get our music going, and I just want to show y'all my picks really quickly. This one has a Superman symbol in the middle, and this one just has the B. But what I really love about these is that the handles are fist, and then they're black. So, like, you know, black baby. Here's what I'll be using. I got a random wig cap. I got a mini pick. Here's it in comparison to the other ones. I got some butterfly clips to go on the fro when it's done, a crochet hook because I didn't know if I had one already, and then two packs of hair. Make sure to screenshot if you need to. And then last but not least is the styrofoam head, and I'm gonna show y'all how to use this stand thingy. You untwist it and then you can move it however you want to, tighten it up, and then it'll stay in that place. And then to connect it to something, you just tighten and loosen the bottom screw and then put it on whatever you want. Before I start crocheting any hair into this wig cap, I'm gonna try it on to see if it's too tight, and it was a little too tight, and maybe not even a little, because I'm trying to feel like, is this gonna start making my head hurt? But then I heard some popping. I was like, oh, let me not rip it. That didn't really do much, but I was like, I don't care, I'm making this wig today. Having already done this, I know a couple things that I want to do differently the next time that I do it, and one thing being that in the beginning, at the nape of the neck where you see I am, I don't want to put everything so close together. I'm actually going to space it out more at the nape of the neck the next time, and as I get closer to the crown of the head, I'll start tightening my spaces. I'll try to explain that a little more visually later, but get some T-pins because my wig cap can falling off. Here you can see what I was talking about by starting off tight, and then as I got to the middle, I loosened it up. Yeah, next time I'm not doing that. In the beginning, I'm gonna be as loose as I am here and then tighten it up in the crown of the head. Now I'm just showing you a close-up of how I crocheted it to the wig cap literally, and also trying to show you my spacing. I'm gonna insert a picture to try to explain it a little better. I did not just randomly put them, I'm spreading them out. You don't want them to be like uniformly lined. This whole time I've been splitting each section into half. Here's what one looks like just straight out the pack, and then I finger detangle the curl loose on both ends, and then from the middle just pull it apart, and if it doesn't come apart all the way, which mine rarely did, just get some scissors and cut the pieces that are stuck together. This is what she looks like after using the whole entire first pack, and with each little bundle being split in half, and she's full as f- and I only used one pack. Now we're gonna get started on the second pack, and I'm still gonna split each bundle in half.
I'm gonna try it on. Here she is. Yeah, this is a tiny ass cap. Imagine. I'm fucking very, very happy right now, so I'm gonna keep going. Oh my god, it's so cool. I have a wig I just made. Can you see?
It looks flat, or it's big.
Hey! 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 Right now, I have an Afro wig!
So I'm gonna insert a picture of the pattern. This is the face. This is the front of my wig where the bangs will be. But because I don't want it to have like a middle part or nothing, this is just gonna be a face framing fro. So really, I've been doing this move the entire way, just been going left to right, all the way until I got to the top, and I was like, okay, I'm getting to the crown. I did start thinking about it a little late, but We're gonna do these, and then keep putting some right here to make them fall forward. And then I can go in and shape it later. But she's huge. In complete love. Can you see her over there? Hold on. This is how much hair I have left to finish the top. A whole nother bundle and then a little bit left, which is more than enough for this.
Think about you, I feel on you, time it comes through. Oh, oh.
I would like to say that I did have a shape that I wanted in mind. However, I did not execute that because I got a little too scissor happy off my head. This is the shape that I wanted. You can see from my wig, that seems very achievable, except for not when you take it off and get too scissor happy without trying it on between then. So yeah, next time that's my goal shape. And this is the last time you see my wig look like this. After this, I took it off my head because it was too big to work with. I cut the rest off my head, and then when I put it back on, this is what it looked like. Although it is not what I originally wanted, I am still very, very, very happy with it. And I mean, it's my first time. It's all about trial and error, okay? Next time, I guess I'm striving for even bigger. When I turn around and flip my head down, you can see there's a little bit of longer pieces in the middle on the back. Yeah, Brandy helped me trim those. But if you don't have another person with you to look at your head, I would recommend recording it and then doing what I'm doing, shaking your head and seeing where you need to fix. Y'all remember how my wig cap might have been a little too small? Yeah, it is. It's too tight. So I took some scissors and I trimmed four corners, like northwest, south, to east, and I trimmed the elastic. Didn't get as far to the wig cap, but just the elastic so it can loosen up a little bit.
So this is the wig. She looks 100% great. Topped off with the hoops and the outfit. Here's hair with the butterflies in it. I just did a couple. I love it. I love it. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. Ooh.
Oh my, that fake ass pH shit.
Let me see. That was fake.
It is fake. They all turn the same color.
Right.
Well, it worked.
Only like a little bit.
Yeah, I'm loving it. This is my wig to throw on. What I wanted was a wig that I could throw on and not have to worry about no edges, no nothing, and just throw that bitch on and reshape. And here she is. I fucking did it. It didn't take long at all. It literally took me less than a day. If I didn't start yesterday and I just started today, I'd probably say it'd take maybe 4 or 5 hours. Maybe that's a stretch. I really don't know. Maybe I'll time myself the next time.